This is video number 32 from digital-university.org, and this is our series of electrical circuit analysis. We thought in this video we would rework a problem that we did, I think it was in video 17, where we solved this bridge type of circuit problem using mesh growth analysis. And we're going to rework the problem in this video using nodal analysis technique. And the reason why it's amenable to that technique is because of this arrangement where here we have a voltage source, and in series with that voltage source is this resistor. So hopefully you'll recognize that from, I think it's video number 22, that with that type of arrangement, is that you can replace this and this with a current source, and this is in parallel with that current source. And the magnitude of the current source is 20 divided by 3. And again, that stems from video number 22, where we considered source conversions, and what is that, a simple circuit, a voltage source and a resistor in series with it. Now, this resistor right here, this might be just simply the internal resistance of the voltage source. But anyway, you can think of this part of the circuit here as being the source part of the circuit. And we're going to plug something into that. And in this case, it was just simply another resistor that we were plugging into it. But the point is that if we replace this voltage source with the current source, and the magnitude of that current source is this voltage divided by that resistor, like this, then you think of this part of the circuit as being the source circuit. We're plugging something into that. In this case, it's just simply another resistor. The point, though, is that the amount of current that flows to the resistor here, or the amount of power that flows through it, is the same as what flows through the resistor when it's plugged into this type of setup. So here, you see we have a voltage with a resistor in series with it. So you can replace that with this type of setup. Here we have a current source, and that same resistor is in parallel with that current source. And again, the magnitude of the current source, that is equal to this voltage divided by the value of that resistor in series with it, 20 over 3. So now that we have same circuit connected to a current source, that makes it amenable now to node analysis. But we have to be careful. This is the bridge part of the circuit. This and this are identical. And the way we have it set up, the current that flows through here to the bridge part of the circuit is identical in both circumstances. However, remember this part of the circuit is considered the source part of the circuit. This is considered the source part of the circuit. And the amount of current that flows through this resistor is not the same when we have it in parallel with this current source. For this, it will be. So again, this we consider as the current part of the circuit, if you were plugging something, or the source part of the circuit. And here, we're plugging this bridge network into the source part of the circuit. And the amount of current that flows through these resistors run a show, it will be identical with the amount of current that flows through these resistors, same setup, same bridge setup, on connecting now to a voltage source. So that's what I'm going to do in this video, being careful as to what's happening with this resistor here. And now when it's in parallel here, we'll pay more attention to that when we get towards the end of the problem. Okay, so right now, our first task then is to look at the circuit and identify all the nodes. And at the bottom part, we can imagine that all of these lines are all conductors. They could just feed into a single point. So there's a single node at the bottom of the resistor, and that node is grounded. And then here, let's look at this point. Here we have this branch, also this branch feeds into that point, and so does this one. So this entire part of the circuit here can be considered as node one. And again, that's going to be at a certain potential, we'll just say V1, yet to be determined. Now, here, we have another node. This branch connects into it, this branch, and this branch connects into it. So that's node number 2, and that will be V2. And then here we have another node. This branch connects into it, this branch, and this branch connects into it, and that would be at a voltage V3. So our job initially is to determine V1, V2, and V3. And we'll do that, we'll set up the equations now. We're going to use the format approach as we developed in the previous videos. So let's do that. Let's get started then, and see if we can determine V1, V2, and V3, and when we have that information, determine the current that's flowing through all of these resistors, and being careful, we pay attention to this resistor. So, let's see, for node 1, we have this resistor, and this one, so we're going to have V1 times 1 over 2, 1 over 4, and 1 over 3. Okay, now, here for this resistor, the other end of it is at a potential V2, so we're going to have minus 1/4 V2. And again, this is the format technique now. Okay, and then we're going to have with this resistor minus 1/2 times that potential V3. And we have 20/3 of current amps flowing into the node. So on this side of the equation, we write that with a positive value. And again, this is the format technique that we have developed in the previous videos. Okay, now let's go to node number 2. Here we have this resistor, 2, 5, and 4. So we're going to have V2. And it's going to be V2 times 1/2. Let's try to keep these in focus. V2 times 1/2 times 1/5 times 1/4. 1/2 plus 1/5 plus 1/4. Now, with this resistor, the other end of it is at potential V1. So we have minus 1/4 V1. And with this resistor, this other end of it is at potential V3. 5 ohms, that's minus 1/5 times V3. And net current flow of that node is 0. Okay, let's go to the third node. Here we have this resistor, this resistor, and this resistor. So we're going to have V3 times 1/2 plus 1/5 plus 1. Some room for this. Now for this resistor, that's at potential V2, so we're going to have minus 1/5 times V2. And then for this resistor, we'll have minus 1/2 V1. And again, for this node, no current source for it, so it's set equal to 0. Okay, so let's go to here. Now, we have voltage V1, V2, and V3, three unknowns to solve for, and we have three equations which to use, so it should be solvable. Let's look at what we have here. 1/2 plus 1/4 plus 1/3. This is 13/12. So we have 13/12 times V1. And here we're going to have minus 3/12. And here minus 6/12. Now here we have 1/2 plus 1/5 plus 1/4. That is 19/20. Minus 1/4, that is 5/20. Minus 1/5, that is minus 4/20. And from here we have 1/5 plus 1 plus 1/2, that is 17/10. Minus 1/5, that's minus 2/10, and minus 1/2, that's minus 5/10. Okay, so let's go to here, our first equation, and if we multiply both sides of this equation by 12, we will have 13 times V1, I'm going to write it down here out of camera range, minus 3 times V2, minus 6 times V3, and that will equal 80. So our first node equation becomes this. Once we clean things up a little bit. Okay, now let's look for this equation. Multiply both sides by 20, and we're going to have minus 5 times V1, and it looks like we're going to have plus 19 times V2, minus 4 times V3. And that equals 0. So there's our second mode equation, cleaned up, getting rid of the fractions. And here, multiply both sides of this equation by 10, and we will have minus 5 times V1. And minus 2 times V2. And 17 times V3. And that was set equal to 0, so this is 0. So here then are the three node equations. Again, we have three unknowns to solve for, V1, V2, V3, and we have three equations. So, three equations, three unknowns, we should be able to determine these without too much bother. So, let's do this. Let's go to the top, make some room. And we'll use the determinant method, as we've been doing in the previous videos. So let's see. Here, what we're going to do is we have three common numbers. 13, we'll call it the V1 column, the V2 column, and the V3 column of numbers. So I'm just going to write them at the top. 13, negative 5, negative 5. Then the next column is negative 3, 19, negative 2. The third column is minus 6, minus 4, plus 17 from here, which we now have up here. So here we have a 3x3 determinant, and we also have these rows of numbers with the equations were equal to 80, 0, 0. This is our V1 column, the V2 column, and the V3 column. I'm cramming things close together because we're going to need some space to work with. Now, to determine V1, V2, and V3, the first thing we have to do is determine that this 3x3 determinant, find the numerical value of it. And I don't think we're going to have time to complete that in this video. So come back, join us in the next video. We'll pick up at this point here. First thing is to determine the numerical value of this 3x3 determinant. Once you do that, they're in position to determine V1, V2, and V3. Then, when we have that information, finally, we can go back to our original circuit and put those in place and then determine what the currents are. So, that's kind of the game plan that's going to happen in the next video. Come back and join us for that video. We'll try and finish off the problem.